Now I hate it when I'm right and raise with the Skywrath Mage. You'd think I'm psychic, clearly, but now we go over to Titan for their second pick, and I'm thinking, oh, can I feel a Shadow Shaman?
Well, it would definitely be a great addition when you have a Death Prophet already, just strength enough to push. Speed up the Roshan as well, potentially. Mm-hmm. But what actually other options are there for the just most common of picks at the moment? I mean, it's so hard to keep them all in mind. I always overlook some of them, but at the moment it looks like most of them have been picked up. The Shadow Shaman would...
Tinker is there.
Oh yeah, Tinker, oh crap, man. No, no, please no.
Getting nightmares, are we?
Well, it's a Tidehunter, I'm fine with that.
I'm actually fine with that. That's the first time we've seen Tide in 3 bloody days. Oh, yeah, yeah. It's good to see the Tide pick. Something different. But Rubik now banned out immediately by Titan. They don't want anyone stealing no Ravagers, and I can completely understand that. But Shadow Shaman banned out by Insidious Idol. I wouldn't be surprised to see a ban out on, say, an Earthshaker right now. Equally, what else could we see a ban out on? Considering it's Insidious Idol, Tusk could be a ban out of choice here.
Yeah, it actually would be nice to see it. Although I would rather see Insidious Idol actually pick it up. Would be pretty fun to see. I mean, last game, it ended pretty damn fast when they played it. Just because they had a pushing lineup and, well, I guess Click and Search had too many lag issues to actually try to fight until the bitter end.
Possibly, but other options here. Titan could choose to ban out the Centaur War Runner. Instead, they'll take away the Viper. Don't want to risk that one, but I'm going to point this out right now. The last two games we have cast with Titan, they have been up against a Razor, and they've picked OD. Could we get another Mushi OD in this game, do you reckon?
It's definitely possible. I mean, it's a pretty strong hero, all in all. Last game didn't really work out for them just because Meepo actually had more intelligence than the OD, but...
That's one of the strengths of the way that Meepo was built, but from where we stand, we've got one more ban remaining for Insidious Idol.
I guess they can still try to eliminate some form of pushing. Something like a Razor is... Not a Razor, the Chikiro is a possibility, I guess, if they want to. But maybe an Ancient Apparition ban wouldn't be too bad here.
An AA ban would make some sense. I would be completely agreed with that one, considering the Ice Blast combination with the Ravage does add up. But we'll actually get the Venomancer ban. So taking away those push heroes. You've got to admit, that is something refreshing for once.
Yeah, it's always nice to see something else banned. I mean, Insidious Idol themselves actually have played, I guess, a moderate amount of Venomancer across the past 2 days here. But as they don't have actually a proper pushing lineup, don't have a Lycan or anything, they didn't want to go for it themselves, so... What are their options? I mean, they banned out the Skywrath Mage themselves. I guess Earthshaker, Wraith King?
Wraith King could work, but there is still a Tinker.
Oh man, don't remind me of that hero! Well, to be honest, for Insidious Idol, it would make sense since Death Prophet, of course, indicates that some pushing will be happening by Titan. But it's a Bristleback instead, so
I like
seeing something slightly different.
I like Bristleback. Bristleback can get on top of Death Prophet, is fairly tanky, can bring down her armor and kill her outright. It's a aggressive choice. It's a fun choice. It's something different. But now for Titan. Where do they go from here? They're fighting into a Bristleback. They've got the Skywrath Mage to deal with as well. They need something that can brawl. They need something that can go toe-to-toe with this. And they've already got the Tide to bring them some control. They've got a Death Prophet for the push. Do we now look for some more control in the form of the supports? A Witch Doctor wouldn't go amiss. I think we can all get behind a Witch Doctor pick, can't we, guys?
Oh, of course, man. Witch Doctor would be pretty awesome in any lineup, Ravage into Death Ward. And actually, Insidious Idol, so far they would have only one thing to stop a Death Ward, the Ancient Seal from Skywrath Mage.
Indeed, I'm expecting some more stuns coming out of Insidious Idol with their final two picks. I mean, otherwise they're going to be running very light on stuns, and we know how that goes. But we get the Enchantress, which is going to bring more pushing power as well as control to the table for Titan. I'm liking the Enchantress. That brings you the creeps from the jungle. It brings you the impetus, which is pure damage. Pure damage straight through that Bristleback.
Yeah, and they completely crushed Click and Search, I do believe it was yesterday, with an Enchantress as well. Just excellent early rotations, actually starting in the enemy jungle to begin with. Early rotations into the mid lane and crushing the opposition Ember Spirit. But, well, with this Titan, they still have more room for one more support. They already have their offlaner as well as the mid laner. I mean, I guess as far as the safe lane goes, they can go either way, depending on what Insidious Idol goes for. If they actually don't go for anything with proper lockdown. Then something like even a safe lane, Storm Spirit, Weaver, anything that can just completely take advantage of the enemy like in lockdown.
Right now I'm thinking Insidious Idol are going to go for a Vengeful Spirit or a Witch Doctor. Something that can bring stuns and is a good support. Something that can pair with the Skywrath, which is why I'm actually leaning towards the potential for Vengeful Spirit. But other options, we could see the Shadow Demon once again. We could see the likes of a Dazzle. I speak for the genius. It's going to be the Prophet. So, we all know my opinion on the Prophet.
But is this like a tri-lane Bristleback now, or a tri-lane Prophet, or mid-lane Prophet with tri-lane Razor?
Mid-Razor, safe-lane Prophet, aggressive tri-Bristleback, so I'm thinking Witch Doctor for their final hero, and it also does bring the heal to help accelerate that push. Also, extra things to bounce the cask on, considering you've got the Enchantress there, but we get the Ursa for Titan. Oh, this is nice.
Well, this is more than nice, to be honest. Although, I still hope a little bit, just in case, although in Insidious Idol it would be extremely greedy if they went for a Tinker now. If they really wanted, they could run the Nature Prophet in the jungle as well, but I actually don't think they're going to go as greedy. I mean, it would be asking for too much.
I honestly don't see a Tinker. What do Insidious Idol now ban out, though? I mean, we're looking for a support of some type. Could we see a ban on Wraith King? That could work.
I mean, it wouldn't be bad, to be honest. I mean, I wouldn't oppose a Lich too much, although it would actually mean that Titan themselves are extremely low on proper lockdown, because at the moment, it's actually Ravage that's their only stun.
That is very true. Some kind of stunning support would be good. And again, the Witch Doctor does come to mind.
Yeah, Wraith King actually would be good, just Vampiric Aura with Ursa.
Yeah, there's your Wraith King ban. I my gut was right. I don't like arguing against my gut. But we get a Sand King ban out for Titan. And someone in chat, we have a call from chat for a Necrolite. If we see a Necrolite, you have my thumbs up. I'm more than happy to see a Necrolite. But oh, hello! That's new! We get a Zeus!
Yeah, going Balkan Bear style, Nature's Prophet plus Zeus. If they time it correctly, Thunder God's Wrath giving vision on every single hero with Wrath of Nature to bounce around afterwards. Plus, of course, Ancient Seal into Zeus. Holy crap.
Ancient Seal into Zeus is going to be absurd. This is the lightning strap. We've got Eye of the Storm. We've got Thunder God's Wrath. This is the kind of thing that I'm going to enjoy. Ah, it's such a refreshing from the last games we've had. We've got a Batrider for the final hero of Titan. So I will point this out. Potential for level 1 Roshan on the side of Titan because of the Ursa. Going to be something to keep in mind. But from where we sit, I think we're in for a cracker of a game. So this is where I turn around and I do my usual. Who are you betting on, Couch?
Well, I mean, you can't go up against gods, man. I'm going for Insidious Idol.
I want to bet on Insidious Idol, but
I mean, I can take Titan as well, man. I love myself some bears, man. Ursa.
Both of these lineups are unorthodox, and I like to always think unorthodox is the line between genius and insanity.
I think Insidious Idol might have just a slightly easier to execute lineup.
Easier to execute, I would agree with, but Titan's lineup? I'm actually going to favor Titan's lineup because the Batrider gives you that initiation. Zeus doesn't have any escape mechanism. Bristleback is very much the same, and if you can annihilate him quickly, that's going to be a very big thing. On the flip side of this coin, you do say that Insidious Idol have the easier to run lineup where you've got Thunder God's Wrath, you've got the Nature's Wrath, and then you've just got the sheer damage of the Razor and the Skywrath Mage. So it's a case of glass cannon versus tricky execution. But from where we stand, let's introduce the players, shall we?
Indeed we shall. So for Insidious Idol up on the Radiant side, KS, the stand-in for them, will be playing on the Nature Prophet. Otherwise, I do believe actually first departure player as Ysera playing on the Razor with C-Red on the Skywrath Mage, leaving the last two to be Shagasaurus actually on a support Zeus with Bethel playing the Bristleback.
A support Zeus I don't think I have seen before in this kind of role, but it could potentially work out. I mean, the main thing you need on Zeus is levels, and if you're going to be rotating around getting kills with a Skywrath Mage, and you've got to consider the nuking potential of a Skywrath Mage and a Zeus, that's really going to add up. But for the flip side of this coin, we got Ohio on the Tidehunter. Over on the Batrider, we have WTF, as always. On the mid lane, we've got KYXY handling his Prophet. In the jungle, we've got Extinct handling the Enchantress. And finally, the bear, Mushi. He wants to shred someone with his claws and just get gore everywhere. Oh, I'm going to enjoy this one.
Yeah, and I mean, they already got one rid of one sentry ward action, and they will most likely get rid of the second one as well. They do have their own sentry placed there. So they want to ensure that Xtink can actually farm up freely in the jungle, get the creeps, get the rotations going early. And actually, are they? Yeah, it's actually going to be just double jungle, looks like. Mushi with Xtink. And like level 3 Roshan or something.
That could work. That could work. This is an unorthodox strategy, and you know what? It's nice. But yeah, now, hopefully, touch wood, no more pauses.
I mean, once I saw the Zeus pickup, I actually didn't even look at the rest of the lineup, so coming back for a second for the support Zeus, I think I've seen it maybe a couple of times, but that was a pretty long time ago, and not even sure if it had any success at all, so I'm not too sure what to think of this, because Zeus is usually the hero who needs those fast levels, get the lightning bolt maxed out, and just start blowing up people. But if there are rotations, if they don't work out, if they don't get the levels, can they just... I mean, can they apply early enough pressure so that yours actually won't get off the good start, get that fast blink dagger, and just start killing?
I could certainly see that. The early blink, start killing with a blink dagger very quickly, could work. WTF, if he can get this early blink dagger, or early blink dagger at all on the side of Titan, be it on WTF, be it on Mushi, it's going to be very scary. Mushi's just going to be handling the jungle for now, so we're going to have a very... What's the words I'm looking for? A very experienced distributed team. You've got 3 solo lanes and a double jungle. The double jungle, sure, Mushi and the Enchantress are going to be a little bit behind in terms of levels, but I don't think that matters much in this one. I really don't think that matters that much, considering you're going to have level advantage on KYXY as well as on that Batrider. If there's one thing a Batrider can do with levels, it's massacre. And we are really just looking for a massacre in this game, but look at Ohio. He's sitting happily in the offlane, and, well, I think he just got revealed there. Yes, he did. Z-Red, I believe, can see him. And, oh, no, he didn't see him.
Oh,
wow,
my God.
Okay.
I mean, to be honest, they know the Tidehunter is getting levels somewhere. They must see it, or actually, usually you check the levels and just to see if the enemy is just somewhere in the trees. Usually they're trying to just get themselves around here, just around these trees.
KYXY could be in a bit of trouble, but Crypt Swarm's going to be thrown onto Ysera, and that's going to force him back. They're going to repel that at least for a few seconds.
And now, well, Ohio, he's actually level 2.5, gets a double damage rune as well. He wants to go for straight. Unfortunately, he doesn't have cash for himself, so has to back off for the time being, but in for an offlaner, he got some pretty nice XP there.
Yeah, he did. He got some good experience. He's already got his level 2, and from there on in, we're just looking for more.
Mushi
and Xtink, they're already looking to hunt and kill, and they've got themselves a centaur. In comes the overpower. They're going to put the centaur in to lead the charge. This could be a very dead KS here. I mean, he's standing in, trying to do what he can. In comes the Firefly. He realizes something's amiss now, and with Mushi leading the charge, the tower being tanked up, there's no hope to escape this one, and Mushi will get the first blood shed with, of course, WTF. He got the credit for that, so the extra money goes onto the Batrider. And from where we stand, that's 1,300 gold and a Batrider at 3 minutes in the game. So that's going to be an incredibly quick blink dagger.
Yeah, it's scary if a Batrider gets a blink dagger as fast. Especially since Titan now, they got their first rotation to actually work out for them. Getting some extra levels from that, and Enchantress about to hit level 3, the same for Mushi, and I mean, level 1 Roche, or not level 1, but early Roche for them, it's rather easy. I mean, I think even at TI4 we saw a couple of similar strategies. Fnatic running at first, I think. Just Enchantress and Ursa, early Roshan, and they're going to get more than enough levels from just killing it early.
I would completely agree, and the early Roshan will be the order of business in my mind here. But when I see the bottle continue to be crowed by the courier, and I think maybe a little bit longer until we see Xtink and Mushi, of course, rotate into that pit. And we can got to consider what Mushi's got right now. He's got 600 gold. He's almost got enough for that Morbid Mask. It's that Morbid Mask we're looking for. And I'm honestly going to be expecting some very early wards from the side of Insidious Idol looking to ward out that Roche pit. If they can control the Roshan, it's going to be something to keep in mind here. Insidious Idol actually must control Roshan. If they don't control Roshan against an Ursa, that's going to be a big detriment to them. As we stand in this game, I've got to consider, for the most part, how the Bristleback is doing. And he's top of last hits right now. He's got his Bacillus. We're going to be looking potentially for a Vladimir's on Bethel, which would help their team out to a small extent, nothing major. Other options we could see for him, you could look for a Vanguard just to tank up, could look for some early treads. And there are a few options you can go with the Bristleback, but certainly the flexibility of the hero in terms of what item build you want is one of the Bristleback's strengths. You can go for an Armlet, you can go for a Vanguard and tank up, you can go Vanguard Pipe. We've seen that in recent games as well. There are a couple of other options we could go for.
You mean they could even go for a mech on him and leave his hero to go for straight up Aghanims, for example, on the Razor, something like that. But Smoke into Roshan, man. Who needs a Morbid Mask? He actually has enough money for it, but they don't care. They have even Illusions to tank it up, I think. Set the Tormentor for the Hell region, and man, it's gonna take some time, but there's no idea for Insidious title, at least doesn't look like it at the moment. And man, this game is off to a great start for Titan. First blood for them, WTF, working towards it. Fast Blink Dagger, and even Roshan now.
Yeah, but got to consider, Roshan could at least get one kill here. Extinct's going to have to be a little bit careful. They're going to toggle the aggro. And, yeah, Mushi will be able to finish this one off, but that was a little bit risky, I'll grant them that. They had more than enough with the Illusions to tank up as well, but with an early Aegis like this, Mushi can start doing some work. All it would have took was one rogue bash, Extinct could have died there, I'll say.
Well, to be honest, at the moment, in Searside, they even smoked up to try to go there, but they were just a little bit too late. If they had done it like 10 seconds earlier, they actually might have gotten easy kills, but they might get the Hoyo nonetheless. He's going to get slowed down, Concussion Shot, Vicious Nasal Go, KS TP's in as well. And he tried to kill Steel here, KS, but Bristleback, he got it.
Bristleback picking up the kill is going to suit him all well and good, and he's already got his treads, so we're looking to start tanking up on Bristleback so he can brawl in these fights, or we could, of course, see the Armlet build if he really wants to be that right-click force of nature, which equally would work. And we do have TP's defense from KYXY, but he isn't enough on his own. They need more rotations than just the Death Prophet. And in my mind, they're going to need a rotation down from the Batrider. And considering Batrider does have his Tranquils, has his bottle, he didn't opt for the immediate Blink Dagger, but he's farming up well enough without it. I mean, as soon as he gets the Blink, we're going to be looking at about a 9-minute Blink, if that, maybe even less. WTF will be able to just cause all manner of havoc, be it mid lane, be it top lane or bot. Nothing will be able to escape the Batrider's sight.
Yeah, it's just Batrider early Blink Dagger is always scary. I mean, no matter what heroes you actually have, and so far, or in their lineup, they actually have nothing to go super defensive, but oh, he wants to go for KS.
Yeah, he wants to go for KS, and with two stacks of the Sticky Napalm, that's not going to be anywhere near enough. And I suppose the Firefly is just one of those tools which force a Nidus Prophet off the lane, because the risk of him getting killed, I mean, it's one of the strengths of the Batrider. It creates so much havoc in terms of the lane control, the momentum with the Firefly. It just makes you run away whenever you get too many stacks.
By the way, what do you think of Nidus Prophet's item build, or overall the trending item build of Triple Null Talisman?
We're looking for a blade mail, aren't we?
And it's actually not too bad, I guess, against Ursa. Ursa Champ should just activate blade mail. Run into Death Prophet Exorcism, or rather Exorcism trying to chase you, so you activate blade mail. Plus the bonus armor aspect of it. It's not bad, but what is your take on it overall?
My opinion of it is it's going to be irrelevant as soon as Mushi gets a BKB. So speaking of kills, by the way, we do lose the Tidehunter in the middle lane, Ysera, on that Razor, doesn't mention clean that one up. But as soon as a BKB comes up for Mushi, that KS with a Blade Mail will be absolutely irrelevant. Mushi will just maul him, as a bear rightfully should.
Yeah, that is for certain at the moment. And well, Titan, they have slowed down, or actually, they haven't been their usual aggressive selves. Usually, oh, actually, KS, they're gonna get like, so 3 stacks of Sticky Napalm in the Firefly, TP's are coming in, 4 stacks. Actually, can Nature Prophet make it out with Shagasaurus being there to help out? They actually save KS, so Nature Prophet, first lasso, kind of a fail, but he has enough for a Blink Dagger.
Yep, I completely agree. With that Blink Dagger up now, we could be looking for more kills. And it's only a matter of time before we see a 4 star from the Batrider, and once we get that, it's really going to cause the positional chaos that we come to expect of a Bat. But I will point out with the Zeus, we are seeing the support Zeus, of course, and now he's got his point in the static field. I was honestly expecting an earlier point in static field just because of the damage that it does to the area, and they're going to just deward. This is a very good ward spot, by the way. It gives a good amount of vision across the board of this top lane, and Shagasaurus will take that one out.
That's actually one of the better things about the Zeus as well, the ability to do so. It's a little bit like a Slark. I mean, Slark can usually spot out ward vision or where the wards are when his shadow dance breaks, but he can just use the most common spots. But there's a Smoke, Extinct, and Mushi. They want to go for Seared, or well, anybody else for that matter, and they're gonna get at least one kill here, I think.
Yep, in the back lines, you do get Mushi mauling the Skywrath Mage, but I was taking a look at the attempt on Bethel. Bethel, he'll go down to this as well. Mushi, he's sure low health, but he has that Aegis still for a few more minutes. And if they can kill the Bristleback, that's going to be pretty damn huge, because this is going to be a case of, we're just going to take this tier one. With Exorcism up, especially now they're going to force the Aegis, so they'll have a full health Mushi. This is going to be very hard to stop. I mean, you can't fight into Exorcism this early, but it will be a tower for a tower. Razor clears up the tower in that middle lane with a DD rune, and if Titan can't equalize the tower differential right now, it's going to be advantage Insidious Idol, especially that's the mid-tier one down. That's going to give you good position over Roshan, keeping that tower offline.
Well, looks like Titan, they definitely will get this tower turn, although Insidious Idol, they're coming in maybe a little bit too slow, though.
Well, in comes the TP coming out of the Bristleback. This is going to be more than enough. They can go for Ohio. He's going to be silenced up and absolutely killed. He won't be able to cast his Ravage, and now Excalibur's going... Sorry, Extinct's going to be the target, but it does not matter. You've got the jump in from WTF, looking to do some good damage to Chaos, but Chaos will survive this one at least for a little bit longer, and WTF will go down to the Zeus. Honestly, this Zeus is working out for him so far, but in comes the Crypt Swarm, does finish off that Skywrath Mage, and that should be all she wrote. But then again, you still got Mushi in the nearby vicinity, and Bethel is here with that vicious Nasal Goo, so could look for a chase down onto Bethel here, especially considering Ohio is in the vicinity with a Ravage, but they don't have enough damage to kill Bristleback at this point.
So, how many heroes she went down? It's
three.
Tidehunter, Titan, Batrider. Okay, so two cores went down for Titan.
Yeah,
for actually, Ohio bought back as well for some reason.
Okay, he wanted to come in with the Ravage, but I suppose it was a case...
Oh, but they're finding the enemy stack.
Yeah, the enemy stack is the key thing here. They were going to stack it up for the Bristleback, we just cleaned that one up. But now you've got Mushi rotating in. This stack is at least 300, 400 gold, if not slightly more. So this is a good thing going the way of Titan right now. Just keeping that Bristleback down as long as humanly possible.
And one thing that's definitely going to hurt Insidious Idols in the long run at the moment is their supports. They're still only level 4. So actually, well, C-Red, he's level 5 now, but our top lane KS, he's going to be in a lot of trouble. WTF, he finds him, doesn't have the lasso, but doesn't really need it. Saving the flame break just in case when KS starts to TP out, but...
It doesn't matter either way, but in comes Ysera with that Skars Mage to back up. If they can bring that WTF, that'll be huge, but Ysera is just standing in the fire. If there's one thing you don't want to do, it's stand in the fire, and he will go down. WTF gets a double kill.
Well, that, I guess you can call it a gank from Insidious Idol with the three heroes. Completely failed, backfired heavily so, losing the core. At least he got his mech recipe before dying, had the gold for it, but 6-4, two cores down and just Titan. All of their heroes are actually getting so much. We talked about them being rather XP heavy, or that they need a lot of XP. Of course, they had three solo laners to begin with, but I didn't expect it to go that well for them.
No, nor did I. That was actually really damn good. Sure, they lost the tier one, but it does not matter. You've recovered in that lane. KOX might just got an extra kill as well onto the Zeus. Shagasaurus hanging around far too long. So advantage Titan, 7-4 in terms of kills in their favor, as well as 500 gold and 4,000 experience. But we've got to consider maybe a little mistakes, maybe slightly being on tilt from Insidious, considering rule one, I think, of all gaming, never stand in the fire.
Yeah, it literally works for every single game. Don't stand in the fire.
But now comes the push coming out of Titan, and this is the scary thing. There's only so much Bethel can do to try to hold this, so he's going to use his Quill Spray just to try to deal with the creep wave, but the Exorcism is there, and just the sheer power coming out of KOX wave. But now you've got KOX wave trying to get the turnaround here, and Bethel could be in a lot of trouble, but in comes WTF. He's going to lasso Bethel, bring him back. We have a Ravage to go. No, he gets silenced. He's going to pop it with the Kraken Shell, and now we get the turnaround. They drop the Ravage. That cleans up the Bristleback, but equally now you've got Extinct looking to bring down KS. KS in the sidelines, and you'll lose your Tidehunter to an Arcane Bolt, but now they're going to look for Extinct. They're catching with the silence and the Zeus Lightning Bolt. That's going to be more than enough to clean that one up. I mean, this is the strength of the Ancient Seal. It empowers everything to such a big degree. 36% more magic damage taken. And Zeus hits for 350 magic damage at level 4. That was level 3, so it's still 275. It's a large amount of nuking power coming out of a Zeus. Plus the percentage magic damage with the static field. It's incredibly large.
They turned it around rather nicely, although I still think Bristleback went in a little bit too soon. Didn't have the proper team back up there. I just... heavily underestimating the power of Exorcism, even though it was only level 1 at the time, I believe. KS actually almost got KYXY as well, it was one right click away. but just a little bit too fast on his feet with Witchcraft being maxed out and face boots. But we do have that Blade Mail finish now for KS. And oh, Mushi, he jumps on me, Blade Mail activated, but he's using it to run away with Wrath of Nature as well. And Mushi actually, well, this time around, it was enough to just make Mushi back off, and they're not
turn
done.
Around. No. In comes the Thunder God's Wrath. That was the final tick of Nature's Wrath hit the hit Mushi. And Mushi was already forced back to that Blade Mail. The Blade Mail paying off by all means in this game so far. And sure, they may stop attacking you, but if they're low enough, Shagasaurus will just pop Thunder God's Wrath, and then you get the, well, the wrath and ire of a god looking down on you.
That's actually a pretty huge kill overall, just stopping the momentum of Ursa. And actually, after he gained this Blink Dagger in what, like, 3 minutes ago at least, they haven't done all that much with it. WTF blinks in just to destroy the creep wave to slow down the push, which he definitely will succeed with. But KS Sprout, of course, doesn't do anything when the Firefly is activated.
Nope, not a chance. And Chaos will just stand in the fire with the Blade Mail activated. This is strategic gaming coming out of KS on that Nature's Prophet. It will be a case this is going to be a tier 1 in the mid lane. Equally, though, it's going to be a tier 1 in the bottom lane for Titan to defend here, and that one will be killed by the Nature's Prophet. They didn't manage to finish off the mid tier 1 with the Exorcism, so they at least get a match point advantage in terms of towers in the favor of Insidious Idol. But from where we stand right now, I mean, I'm expecting more fight coming out of Insidious Idol. They have the ability to brawl. Sure, they have to respect the Ursa and the Ravage combination with the Tide, but if Insidious Idol can take fights and assassinate players before and get pickoffs before a team fight starts, it's going to be huge, especially if it's Mushi on that Ursa. But from where we stand right now, it's going to be an interesting game, because look at the sheer magic damage potential for Insidious Idol. Mystic Flare, Thunder God's Wrath, Lightning Bolt. I'm expecting a Vial of Discord somewhere for Insidious Idol, and that's just going to empower them to such a large degree. And now with this smoke, they could be looking for Extinct, but it's going to be two smokes revealing. No, Extinct doesn't have a smoke, that's an Invisrune. They're just going to bring down Ohio. Thunder God's Wrath popped as well, and they're looking for more off the back of that one. That did reveal Extinct, but he's going to be forced back. He doesn't want to mess with that one, and WTF is in the sidelines as well, looking for what he can, and Zeus keeps throwing lightning bolts up to that high ground, revealing it for a few seconds, and just ensuring there are no shenanigans on the way in the form of a Batrider. But still, it's a good exchange for Insidious Idol. They're more than happy to come in and commit just their ultimates to kill the Tidehunter. And if they can keep Tidehunter out of these battles, that's going to take Ravage off the table. Without Ravage, Titan lose a lot of their force and their power.
Yeah, it's actually really important to do that, keep that Tidehunter down. And actually, he's going for a first item mech, but since a lot of his ancients got stolen by Bethel, just Quill Spray as well as right clicks, it actually hurts him quite a lot, since delaying the mech. And of course, delaying the mech, in a sense, also delays his next item to Blink Dagger. So the proper initiation for Titan, it's gonna have to be the Batrider through and through. But they are trying to go for KS and probably will succeed. Yes, Blink! Man, this is gonna be such an easy kill.
Yeah, if they catch him with the Batrider and before he can get a Blade Mail up, that's going to be pretty much the Nature's Prophet dead on demand. And now we get the Exorcism pop, they're gonna look for this tier 1 on the top lane, and there's gonna be no way that Insidious Idol can defend this one, in all honesty. Sure, they've got their Zeus, they've got their nuking power, but you can't really fight into Exorcism like that. And I would not be surprised to see KYXY build defensive in this one. He's going for a BKB next item. Hell, a casual cloak would not go amiss for any of these heroes on this team, considering how much sheer magic damage there is coming out of Insidious Idol. But the Concussive Blast is thrown, but they're not going to be able to catch KYXY. That's the strength of Witchcraft as well as Phase Boots. Good luck catching him. And on top of all of that, there's a Yules as well.
Oh man, he targeted the ground with that, I think, and got the mini stun from it. And KS actually is going to get the Sprout onto KYX as well. They need a little bit more help. Yules is there, but Ysera is going to come around. He's pretty damn speedy himself, but KYX is still just a Yule Scepter a little bit too much for Insidious Idols to handle.
That's a 443 move speed Death Prophet before he pops phase. He's nearly max move speed with phase boots up. You're not going to catch that, not with the Razor, not with the Nature's Prophet. Sure, we saw a little bit of exchange in the jungle, but equally the rune and the fight that went the way of Insidious Idol. But now we've got a Roche fight engaging. Ysera going to be draining all of the damage out of Extinct, and you've got KS here as well. They're going to try to just kill her outright, and two more right clicks could do it, but nowhere near enough in time. The Razor can't finish him off, doesn't have the attack speed at this point in time. And it could be a case of, this is a pit fight, this is a Roche battle now. They need to engage and they need to catch Bethel or Ysera. But then again, in comes the damage onto WTF. They can bring down WTF, that would be huge. but at least forcing them back for now. It will be Roshan at this rate in favor of Insidious Idol, but Ohio's going to come forward, tank it up as best he can, but he's silenced again. He's not going to be able to Ravage. This is a second time he's not been able to cast it because of a good silence. One blink forward from KS is going to be more than enough, especially with that Arcane Bolton. Just, you cannot find the Ravages on Ohio for this one.
Holy crap, man. What a fight for Insidious Idol's Dake Titan. They were so close to actually finishing up Roshan there. Like 5 seconds, maybe 10 tops, and they would have gotten it themselves, since of course the Fury Swipes stacking up. And not only do they get the Rosh, the Aegis, they're also gonna get the tier 2 tower plus Ohio killed. I mean, that was probably as good of a fight Insidious Idol's could have ever asked for.
2,000 gold plus an Aegis effectively from the towers and the Roshan, as well as on top of that the extra kill onto the Tidehunter. That's easily 2.2k gold. From where we stand, that's going to cause problems for Titan. We can look at the graphs and just show the impact there. That's a 3,000 gold swing, the way of Insidious Idol, as well as bringing the experience back to nearly the zero mark. Titan have to be careful with these next few fights, and more important than anything, they need Ohio to be on point with these Ravages and that mech. If he gets brought down before he can cast Ravage, he's effectively a walking ward at this point. Ravage is what makes Tide. Sure, Anchor Smash is nice as well, but if you have Ancient Seal and the ability to lock him down so he can't Ravage in a fight, you pretty much win every single fight as Insidious Idol. And we've seen how powerful their nuking potential is. Sure, that's going to pop Kraken Shell, but they can just then throw the Ancient Seal after the ults are dropped and he'll die before he can cast Ravage. This is perfect play coming out of Insidious Idol.
Yeah, and so far, nobody's too close to a BKB as well. KYXY trying to work on his, actually, well, he's the closest, needs only a recipe's worth of gold. Mushi a little bit farther away, so about halfway through. Before they get those items, it's going to be extremely hard for them to fight, especially since Insidious Idol, man, Chagasaurus, he is about 150 gold away from that Veil of Discord.
Indeed, and that Veil of Discord is going to be the item that makes this game, in my mind. The extra magic damage, 25% vulnerability, and we get the blink in on KS. In comes the Zeus, but everyone is here. It's a massacre. Mushi will go down, but they lost the Nature's Prophet in that one in exchange. They're going to have a fight WCF, but they're all swimming through the fire. The fire really doesn't do much, though, at this point in. There aren't any Napalm stacks, and WTF will equally take a fall. So that's a 2 for a Nature's Prophet. Quite favorable for Insidious Idol.
Yeah, it definitely is, and almost, just almost, they even managed to survive or keep the Nature's Prophet alive as well. But KYXY in the meantime, level 2 Exorcism, trying to do the split pushing work, just going for the tier 2 tower. TPs are coming in, although the tower just takes so much damage. Bethel gonna get silenced up as well, and does Priestback really want to go solo up against Exorcism?
I think Bethel, of all the heroes, can tank up against the Exorcism at this point. I mean, it's hitting him in the back right now, and that's at least giving him the damage reduction, and KYXY is forced to TP out. I think that was the right call by Bethel. He can tank it up. He's the only one that can. But from where we stand, other things to consider for Insidious Idol right now. Veil of Discord's online for Shagasaurus. And if he can get that on multiple targets, then they drop, say, Nature's Wrath, Thunder God's Wrath.
Oh, Mushi in so much trouble. Haste on Ysera is going to come in on the Razor as well. They need to keep the damage going. The Force Staff is going to be enough. Actually, they won't follow up anymore since the Battle Rider came in. I was so certain he's going to go down there.
I was inclined to agree with you. If Mushi would have got caught out, that was going to be it, and unfortunately couldn't catch him in time. But equally, we do have Bethel lurking nearby. Ohio's going to be the focus once more, gets hit with the concussive blast. In comes the TP from KS. He gets silenced once. Thunder God's Wrath, everything dropped. They lose the Tide again. This is how you deal with Tide. You just nuke him. You bring him down before he can even breathe.
Yeah, and that was a Veil of Discord boosting up all of the damage as well there. And actually, Ysera, he had a lot of gold. He had like 3.8k the last time I looked at him. I thought like he's gonna finish up his Aghanim's. Already had a point booster, but he's going for a Shiva's card. He's only 150 gold away from it, but Razor Shiva's card. What's your take on that?
I can understand why he's done it. Delaying the Aghanim's, though, is the interesting thing. I mean, he's pretty much said, okay, I've got some points, some health and some mana from this point booster, but now I want a Shiva's. What's the Shiva's going to accomplish? Slows down the Death Prophet so she can't chase. Slows down the Ursa so he can't chase. It pretty much means the Ysera is nigh invincible in this next fight. It is an incredibly smart item choice in some ways. I mean, how do you deal with Ursa? You kite him. Is there any better kiting item in the game than a Shiva's Guard?
I have to discard the...
That's single target.
Well, I guess, yeah.
And that requires you to attack him, whereas you can just pop Shivas and run.
They are on the hunt. They smoked up, but don't look. Doesn't look like they'll find anything. Maelstrom finished on KS in the meantime. So, well, Shiva's card, is it also finished now? Yes, it is.
I'm liking the next potential fight for Insidious, though. They just have so much amplification. And you've got to consider, Shiva's does 200 damage. A flat 200. There's going to be none of that resisted because of the Vial of Discord. They're putting all of their bets onto magical damage and the ability to kite and slow out Mushi. And it's the right call. But when Mushi gets his BKB, that's at least going to buy them some time. But we get the mass TP away. Equally on the flip side of this coin, though, there is a smoke from Insidious Idol. They're hunting through the enemy jungle, looking for whatever they can find. But there's no one here. No one wants to risk getting caught out of position, and everyone is back in the base. And do you honestly blame them? You're fighting into what is a 7,500 gold lead for Insidious Idol, as well as a neutral experience point. Sure, levels are about equal, but there is so many tier 3 items now available for Insidious Idol. Shiva's Guard, Veil of Discord, tier 2 item, sure, but it does so much for this team. It could equivalently be a tier 3 item. We're going to have a 4 staff soon for Z-Red. Over on the Bristleback, though, he's got himself a Pipe and the Vanguard. Now he's building into a Sand, which will be a Heaven's Halberd, most likely. More lockdown on Mushi. Keep him out of these fights before he can do anything, and that's how you deal with it.
Yeah, it's looking good for Insidious Idol, just getting the next set of items as well as overall. I mean, they will always have the Nature's Prophet to split push and make it so the Titan actually are the ones who have to back off first. But not only that, just the free cores, all of them on Insidious Idol, they are pretty much having the exact same amount of farm in network, only like 400 difference between them. They're going for the tier 2, whereas Titan, they can do nothing about it except for just try to get some towers in return.
Yeah, it's going to be an attempted tower trade, but the tier 2 won't fall at all here for Insidious Idol. Instead, Insidious Idol don't care about the tier 2, they're just going to push for this tier 3. And Titan need to come back to defend at this point, but can they hold it? They're going into two Thunder Gods, effectively, as well as the Bristleback with all that negative armor and all its glory. This is going to be an incredibly hard defense, and it's all going to come down to the positioning of this Tidehunter. If Tide can get a Ravage off, it can make or break the fight. I cannot stress that enough.
Yeah, man, we haven't seen a Ravage for a really long time, and so far Bristleback, he's the one in the front lines as well. If they catch him with the Lasso, with the Exorcism, I think they can still burst down the Bristleback rather fast as well, with the Tidehunter just being the buffer between Bristleback and the rest of Insidious Idol's team.
I'd agree. I would completely agree. And you got WTF with that Blink Dagger 4 staff ready to lasso and grab someone. If he can grab the Bristle and he can kill it, sure. But if he can grab anyone else, specifically, and I stress this, the Zeus, if they can kill Zeus, this is going to be absolutely insane for Titan. But the reason I say Zeus, how much damage can Zeus actually do mathematically? Consider this. He can cast 4 spells in 3 seconds. Those 4 spells will all trigger the static field, which is 44% magical damage to everything around him. He is the engine for this team. He was a support Zeus to begin with, but all he needs to do is cast in the vicinity and he just kills everything. And while all that's going on, the rest of the team will capitalize off the rapidly falling HP of Titan. That's why the Zeus works in this kind of mindset. And sure, Zeus generally doesn't have much in terms of escape. This entire game, Insidious Idols have been the aggressors. They have been the ones in the enemy's face. So it's not a case Zeus needs to escape, and Zeus doesn't initiate these fights either. So the Zeus is working perfectly.
Yeah, and they're getting what is necessary to actually deal with Mushi as well. Even if Mushi finishes his BKB now, there's going to be 2 four staffs finished at the same time. Z-Red already has his.
Ohio's in a lot of trouble. His TP gets immediately cancelled by a lightning bolt on his top lane. Thunder God's Wrath as well. This is going to be more than enough. The silence comes in from KYX, but it's too little, too late. They'll clean up Ohio once more, and everyone needs to fall back to their base at this point.
Oh, man. And actually, the Tidehunter Ohio finished up a 4 staff before dying there. So, went for a 4 staff instead of a blink. Lower range, but I guess you can use it even after the Thundergod's Wrath, which is a nice idea. Otherwise, Thundergod's Wrath might just completely screw the initiation of Titan themselves or the counter initiation. So, not opposed to the 4 staff. PKB finished on Mushi as well, which is huge. PKB was finished on KYXY quite some time ago already.
Well, it's the BKBs that will potentially turn this fight. BKBs are downright required for Titan. Hell, they technically could use a BKB on all of their heroes just to survive this magical onslaught of Insidious Idol. But I never like to count out a team, and if any team can hold this one, it's Titan. However, they need to target this Zeus and bring him down near enough immediately. But to get to Zeus, you're going to have to go through a Shiva's Guard, Razor, as well as the Nature's Prophet and Skywrath Mage. All the while, Bristleback will be waylaying on you as well. This is going to be a very rough and hard fight for Titan, but if any team can do it, I think it's Titan.
Yeah, it most certainly is at the moment. And actually, KYXY has a level 3 exorcism as well, so he is more or less capped out unless they start getting some minus armor, get an AC or something like that. Maybe Medallion on Extinct, which is usually the item we see on Enchanter, especially if Titan are playing it. But all
Chaos
the
gets grabbed. Pops the blade mouth. He should just walk away from this one. There's no risk of that one. There was no teammate close enough that could help WTF, unfortunately. Mushi tried to get there, but just doesn't have the movement speed to get across this battlefield. Sure, you got the blink dagger, but that far a jump, you're not going to go. Not going to fly.
Just look at how close the Bristleback and Deathrohit are farming to each other. They didn't even know the other one is there, but I guess Bristleback doesn't really care all that much. We play Pipe, we play Heaven's Albert now finished up as well.
He can just go aggressive. He can go aggressive. He doesn't particularly care too much about Ohio, and you've got to consider, he also has a Pipe, so he's going to mitigate the Crypt Swarms, he's going to mitigate some of the Ravage damage. It really does add up, but now in the middle lane, we do have that potential for a brawl starting to develop. I mean, you've got to consider, they've got a DD, WTF, sure, that's not a major thing, but more importantly, they have all of their ultimates online, as almost except the Lasso, which will be up in 10 seconds. This is the makings of the next big fight. And you've got to consider, Roshan is now available once more. Equally, Insidious Idol know this, it's revealed. And we could see a brawl over this next Roshan. This next Roshan could decide the entire game. And honestly, I think that is going to be the case, considering this next Aegis will be life and death, effectively, for Titan. If they get the Aegis and put it onto Bethel, it's near enough over. The Bristleback can just walk up onto the high ground and not give a damn.
Yeah, but for Insidious, I think, or at least I'm pretty positive that they want to get at least one kill before going into Rosh Pit themselves. Because, yes, so far they have been winning fights, but Ravage overall into the Rosh Pit. Batrider, of course, one of the best heroes to defend against Roshan attempts as well. And, oh, can he get the initiation? Possibly. He's on the high ground, he's gonna go in, but he gets slowed down before he gets anything. Silence, Mystic Flare, he goes down. Thundercross, Rack, Mushi, BKB is there, but he just has to run away.
All his damage was drained through that BKB, and that just all went sideways. He didn't get the catch onto the Zeus that he needed, and now comes the chase. Bethel will take a good amount of damage from this Exorcism. Of course, I believe this is a level 3 Exorcism now. Yes, it damn well is, and they're going to try to turn this. They're going to try to chase, but pings go out onto Ohio from Jagasaurus. They want to kill this Tidehunter if they want to re-engage, but can they afford to at this point? I mean, they've already used their Mystic Flare, they've used their Thunder Gods, they've used all of their ultimates. Do they really want to think about engaging Exorcist and Death Prophet? I don't think they will, so it'll be a case of reset. We're going to help ourselves to Roshan. Now, unless we see some form of attempt to defend this by Titan, which I honestly don't think we will, at least not in time, we're going to get an Aegis for Insidious Idol. Who do they put the Aegis on? Do they put it on Ysera? It seems so. He's got the open slot. Bethel, he's tanky enough as is. I mean, he's got 2,000 health. He's got huge magic resistance. How much magic resistance does this guy have? He's got 47%. On top of all of that, he's got evasion. 30% worth of evasion. Bristleback is going to be nigh impossible to kill, at least not without some sublime luck with those dodges coming out of Mushi or an MKB. And an MKB is going to be a very important item in this game. But the case of this is, an MKB is a very expensive item equally. I want to say 5,400 golds worth of item. But how can they afford this? Mushi doesn't have enough and he needs to hold for a buyback. Same for the Death Prophet, and Death Prophet really isn't a natural MKB carrier anyway. They need the MKB on Mushi, and he just doesn't have the farm, the economy, to afford it.
Yeah, it's just a matter of Ursa not really being the fastest of farmers. I mean, he's still faster than a Chaos Knight, I believe, but it's just he has to whack everybody one by one. Furious Fight help out with the clearing, with the Earthshock as well a little bit. But you can just see him not farming as fast as he really, maybe not should, but in Serious Idol, they are not giving too much space on the map for Titan as well. That's the biggest thing. And Ysera, he's holding onto HGs now. Aegis actually did go into Bethel in the end. So this next fight, Titan, they're going to have to rely on KYXY's ability to tank it up with his newly acquired Heart of Tarrasque. And
it'll
of course,
help.
WTF, he needs to nail the initiation as well.
It will help, certainly, the heart, but it's all going to come down to WTF, in all honesty. And what are you saying? Chaos Knight isn't a slow farmer. He farms heroes.
Yeah, but once you fall behind, you're, like, kind of screwed.
Yeah, I like my Chaos Knight. Chaos Knight's fun. I really wish we saw more of it, but Now we get the potential for initiation. In comes the pipe, though. WTF needs to nail that Zeus, but Shagasaurus is so far at the back lines. They need the jump, but they won't fight it. The other option is they try to grab Chaos, but I don't think that's going to be possible either. And now we get Nature's Prophet. He's going to split us at bottom lane. Now we get the initiation. They go on Ysera, but in comes Thunderbolt Drop. Ravage Drop finally gets a good one, but Bethel is just so damn tanky. BKB's up with KYXY and Mushi. Can they bring down Bethel and get the Aegis? Yes, they damn well can, but all the while this is going on, Chaos ratting. But back in the fight, he's going to respawn with the Aegis, so now Mushi in a lot of trouble. He gets slowed out. The damage comes through from Zeus. Mushi won't be able to stand up to this. He can't go toe-to-toe with this level of damage. And now Z-Red comes in, finishes that one off, and equally KYXY in a lot of trouble as well. Chaos, though, has that blade mail up, absorbs a lot, but not before KYXY can finish him off. Now Bethel, Zeus, and Skywrath are all that stand for Insidious Idol, but can they do enough? I don't think they can. They're all going to fall back, and surprisingly, Titan hold their base. Sure, they took a lot of damage on their tier 3s, hell, both of them, but they hold for now.
Yeah, it was just well-chained ultimates from Titan, I have to say, all in all. First of all, bringing out Ysera on the Razor and actually killing him off before he activates the cheese, that was pretty damn important. If they had lacked only like 1 second of stun lock to kill him off, would have been cheese, suddenly full HP and fight might have gone a whole different way.
They had the CC chain, yeah. They damn well had that CC chain. Flawless.
So, in that fight, Titan, pretty much everything aligned for them. And actually, in Suicide, even with the Aegis, unable to break them, but they haven't given up yet. It's not like they have to wait for super long cooldown ultimates or anything. And now, without the Ravage, this might be the opening in Suicide just have been waiting for. They still have the cheese. And this time around, without the Ravage, I highly doubt that Razor goes down before popping the cheese.
I'd be inclined to completely agree. I mean, it all comes down to this next push, and Razor, he's a little bit wise to what's going to be going on now. But in the meantime, bot lane, KS will kill on Mushi. They get the Hex, they use the Thunder God's Wrath, but Mushi, he's going to TP out. He's going to be safe. They get the Yules as well onto Bethel, so that's going to buy a little bit of time. Now we get the fight. The Brawl's starting all over again. Ohio will be the target. He gets 4 stars out of the Mystic Lair. Not going to connect, but now Ysera shredding the tower, does have his Aghanims, and Eye of the Storm going to do some serious work here, especially with Bethel on the front lines, and we're looking for a jump in. Do we have a lasso? Yes, we do. Do we have Ravage? No, we don't. Not for another 20 seconds. They need Ravage to defend this, and they're going to fall back now. They're going to reset. They're going to re-engage in a few. What do they need to wait on, though? They've got a minute on Thunder God's Wrath at most. They've got Mystic Flare available in 16 seconds. These two ults, in my mind, are all they need. They could wait longer. Hell, they don't even need to wait longer. You've got Nature's Wrath as well in 10 seconds. Everything is coming back online for Insidious Idols. This is going to be quite scary.
Yeah, but by the time now, if they want to re-engage or reinitiate Titan, they have all of their ultimates ready as well. Actually, Ohio, he has another 2.2k gold. Can try to tank up a little bit. KYXY has picked up a plate mail. Just going for raw armor, probably Shiva's card in the making.
Yeah, he needs a Shiva's card. And AC actually wouldn't go amiss. AC is a really good item on Death Prophet, considering her ultimate is all classed as physical damage, but a Shiva's guard would just give her more mana pool. Does she need more mana pool, though? I don't think she does.
I think actually AC would be better just
yeah,
help her.
AC would give
Razor
her more armor. It would give her far more armor than a Shiva's. So I actually like the idea of an AC, but will it be an AC? I have my doubts, considering an AC is considerably more expensive. But now we get a fight starting on the sidelines. Bethel could be the target here. They're going to get the Firefly up from WTF, just scout everything out. No one's going to get caught out by surprise by, say, a Bristleback or a Zeus. But nonetheless, in comes Bristle. Actually, he could go on Ohio here. And who are they going on? They're going on WTF. Thunder God's Wrath to drop. Do we see the Nature's Wrath as well? I don't think we will. And now we get the full Mjolnir, however, on that Nature's Prophet. Now his push is starting to become scary. Not only is his push scary, they've got Static Shield available. You want more lightning than a Zeus and a Razor? Static Shield it is, coming out of a Mjolnir.
Yeah. They really are going for the lightning strat at the moment, like 100% pretty much. And so far it's worked out decently enough, and actually they haven't seen all that many kills. The fights are pretty far between. So looking at the graphs now, it's still about like 8,000 gold for Insidicidal. XP actually has dropped down quite considerably. Only about a 2,500 for Insidicidal. So I mean, Titan, they are definitely not out of this game. They definitely have the initiation power and they're gonna go for it, but the blink, okay, yes, he's fast on his fingers.
Indeed he is, and WTF will be safe on that one. I was taking a look at the bottom lane. That tower's almost dead. The split push coming in from that Nature's Prophet. But now we've got a fight potentially going to break out on this top lane. Bethel is here. Ysera's ready to fight. And it's only going to be the case of who initiates first. Who's going to play this game of chicken? Is it going to be the Ravage? Or is it going to be the jump in with potentially, I don't know, a Bethel just charging in? There is really no hard initiator for Insidious Idol. They just go with what they can get. But here comes the pipe. They're just going to uphill it with the sprout, with the treants. They're going to just commit everything to defend. And Ohio's going to be the target here. He's getting new. He gets four stuffed out. That's going to buy him some time. But now they're just going to collapse on the tower, doing some good damage with that Eye of the Storm. And the tier three will fall. They need to repel this. They need to get some more damage, however. But Bethel has a static shield up and everyone can fall back. Bethel is the initiator and the last one out of the fight. He enters and exits the fight first all the damn time, considering he is the damage sponge. If he can be the last one in, the first one in, the last one out, he just protects his teammates to such a large degree.
Yeah, and you can't really ignore him either, since actually when the Warpath starts stacking up, he actually does a pretty huge amount of right-click damage as well. Kill sprays, I mean, PKBs or not, physical damage will still go through it for Mushi as well as KYXY. And where's the opening for Titan now? They are gaining some gold here, so they're at least keeping things level with Insidious Idol. Insidious Idol, they aren't getting any further ahead. But Titan, they're completely in their own base. Do you really think it's going to just come down to the next Roshan fight here?
It could do, but Roshan, how far away is he? Ooh, actually, he's 3 minutes. He's, 3 minutes? Yeah, 3 minutes away. So, Roshan, it's the longest possible Roshan spawn in the game.
We will know soon enough how long it is, actually. It's, well, 32
seconds.
33 seconds?
No, surely not. That's... I can't read that enough sometimes. Never mind. I thought
it was it's just the additional was... 3 minutes. They always blink red before the 8 minutes just goes up.
Or... Yeah, that's what I was seeing. It was that blink. So Roshan will be available in a minute or two. So once we've got Roshan, that could be the next big thing. And I'd be inclined to agree with you. With a Roshan that short, yeah, it could be the thing that decides this game. But you got to remember this. The entire game, you've had Titan on the defensive. Now they smoke, they want to go offensive, and this is where they can do something. They need to get a good pickoff, though, and Nature's Prophet is a good one. They throw the Flame Break, but it doesn't connect, and you get a blink away by KS. They've used their Blink Daggers, they're not going to be able to catch up in time. Now the Thunder God's Wrath will drop, doing some good damage, forcing everyone back, but in comes the flank. Ysera leading the charge. This is going to be such a catastrophe. WTF will grab the Razor, try to force him away, but it does not matter. The Batrider will fall. He cannot hold this one. Equally, in the jungle, you lose the Tidehunter. So they lose the potential to ravage this one, and where's the initiation? In comes Mushi. He wants a claw, but they pop the cheese. Ysera going to survive to live another day, but... Are we going to see any more off the back of this one? Mushi could be the target here, especially with Shagasaurus front line. The Zeus is very squishy still, however, but in comes the potential for damage. The just sheer damage potential onto Ohio. He'll go down. That's a blink forward, and Shagasaurus says no, drops another lightning bolt. They can just keep up this level of aggression as well. This Zeus has completely balled out of control, and this was a support Zeus, I'll remind you guys. He has done so much damage in this game. KYXY going to be forced back as the melee Rax falls. Rangerax the only one still alive, and KYXY going to go down with three stacks on him. They drop another Thunder Gods, and that's going to be the end of Mushi. It's not the end of KYXY, but Mushi comes in, cleans up the Skywrath Mage. They're just trading blows at this point, however. All of them confined to the base. And, well, they're not dealing with objectives, but it does not matter. They're going to fall back. They're going to get the Rangerax, and GG for game one is called. Insidious Idols will take it.
Well, Titan, they played two games today. They've lost two games today. What is this?
Not what I expected by any stretch of the imagination, but of course there is game number two to come up immediately, and honestly, I want to see a game two today. I really do.
Oh man, God, I'm hoping for one. I seriously am, and I see no way that Titan is not going to go for game two here, or Insidious Idol for that matter, having won game one.
Indeed. So on that note, ladies and gentlemen, we will be back in a minute or two at tops with game number two between Insidious Idols and Titan.